Hey everyone, welcome back to another video in our logging series. Today we're diving into a critical phase of your observability setup, log collection. We'll walk through the many ways you can bring logs into Datadog, from files and containers to applications, browsers, and even out-of-the-box integrations. Now, I want to set expectations up front. This video will be documentation heavy. We're not going to spend much time in the terminal or in the UI. Instead, we'll be referencing and unpacking the official Datadog docs, so you get a broad, complete view of what's possible. The goal here isn't just to show you how to do one thing. It's to arm you with the knowledge to navigate the documentation confidently. Know what's supported and where to go when you need to set things up for your specific stack. At the end of this video, we will also cover two very classic and important configuration options at the agent level to scrub sensitive data and prevent unnecessary costs. So with that in mind, let's jump into our first method. Log collection from the file system. We'll kick things off with the basics, collecting logs directly from the file system. This is one of the most straightforward methods. If you've got access to your host and the right file permissions, you can start tailing log files in seconds. Let me walk you through how to configure this so your local logs flow straight into Datadog. One of the most common logging needs is collecting logs directly from the file system on your machine. To do this, head to the Agent Then Log Collection section in the docs. There, you'll find the article on host-based log collection. The first step is enabling log collection in the agent config. It's set to false by default to avoid unnecessary costs, so you'll need to toggle it on before anything else. Right below, you'll find detailed instructions on how to tail files from your local system. It's straightforward. Pick your log file path and then define two essential values, service and source. We'll go deeper into source in a moment, but here's the gist. Service is the name of your application, and source is a general type, like Apache, Nginx, or Node.js. For example, if you're collecting Apache logs, set source to Apache. I'll also show you where to find the full list of supported sources in Datadog. For Windows, the setup is similar. You'll just point to the appropriate file paths. Now, one common issue we see is that the agent can't access the logs or throws a permissions error. There's a guide in the documentation specifically for this, how to make sure the agent can read the file properly. Be sure to check that both the folder and the file have the correct permissions. The agent needs access to both to successfully read and forward your logs. And that's it. Log collection from the file system is really that simple. Back in the agent settings, you'll find additional options like TCP and UDP log collection, which are also easy to configure. Just ensure the appropriate port is open so you can forward logs to the agent correctly. You can also collect logs from Windows Event Viewer. It follows a similar pattern. As a rule, always define source and service wherever possible, even for private or internal locations. And that's it. With this setup, you're now able to collect logs directly from a file. So we've just covered how to collect logs from a single host using file-based inputs and a Datadog agent. That works great in traditional environments. But what about modern containerized setups? Containers and Kubernetes are everywhere today, and they introduce new challenges for log collection. So next, let's dig into how to collect logs from containers, whether you're running Docker locally or orchestrating with Kubernetes. Stick around. This one's important if you're running microservices or scaling across environments. As you might expect, container logging is a bit different. On the host, containers come and go, and you may not know which ones are running or for how long. With Docker and Kubernetes, there are two main steps. First, enable a few key functions and set the required environment variables. Just like with host-based log collection, you need to enable log collection on the agent. But now, you also need to make sure it's configured to collect from all containers using the right variables. If you want to exclude certain containers from log collection, you can configure that too. Just be sure to define the right variables. This works for Linux, and similar options exist for Windows. You'll also need to mount a few volumes so the agent can access container logs. Keep that in mind when running your containers. For Kubernetes, the setup is quite similar. If you're using the operator, set two key variables, logs underscore enabled, true and container underscore collect underscore all, true. This ensures the agent collects logs from every container running on the host. If you're deploying with Helm, the same parameters apply. And that wraps up the basics of container log collection. As mentioned earlier, it's important to define service and source for container logs too. This can be tricky when the agent is centralized and doesn't know which containers are currently running. That's where auto-discovery annotations come in. You can add log configuration annotations directly to individual containers within a pod. Since a pod can contain multiple containers, you'll want to apply these annotations per container. Let me show you a simple example. In this example, for a container named app, we've set source Java and service example app. We've also added tags, so any logs from this container will automatically inherit them. Since we're targeting containers individually, you can apply separate annotations for each one, ensuring full coverage across the entire pod. Now, while containers and Kubernetes are widely used in modern environments, there's another pattern we often see, especially at scale, and that's the use of log aggregators. Tools like Syslog, Fluentd, Vector, and others act as centralized log routers, collecting logs from various sources and forwarding them downstream. In this section, we'll take a quick tour through the documentation to see how Datadog integrates with these aggregators. You'll learn how to configure them to forward logs into Datadog efficiently, often in just a few steps. Datadog integrates with popular aggregators like Syslog, where you can configure both the source and destination settings. To forward logs to Datadog, configure the destination with the correct source, service, and your API key. The same principle applies to Fluentd, where you can configure both metrics and log collection within the same pipeline. Simply define your destination endpoints to send logs where you need them. Logstash is also supported. With the proper plugin, you can forward logs directly to Datadog. So if you're already centralizing logs through Logstash, just configure the destination to send them onward. Finally, let's look at Vector, a log processor now owned by Datadog. Vector supports Datadog as a sync. You can send logs from various inputs and transforms directly into Datadog with just a few configuration lines. Just be sure to include your API key, either through environment variables or a config parameter, along with the correct Datadog endpoint. There are also additional options, like specifying the Datadog site, for example, US, EU. That's the most commonly used setting. You'll usually see it referenced right at the top of the docs. If you're using a different Datadog site or custom variables, adjust accordingly. Those details may be more relevant to your setup. Another common source of logs comes directly from your applications and even your users' browsers. While I generally recommend starting with real user monitoring, RUM, to get structured insights from front-end interactions, it's still worth knowing that log collection is also supported for both applications and browser environments. In this section, we'll walk through the relevant documentation to see how you can capture these logs and forward them into Datadog when needed. Your applications, whether web, Android, iOS, or Flutter, are another frequent log source. For those, head to the relevant documentation pages and follow the initial setup instructions. It's nothing too different. Just configure your destination to be Datadog and you're good to go. That said, for some platforms, I'd recommend starting with Datadog RUM. It's designed specifically for front-end logging and offers more context. Front-end monitoring with RUM often provides more useful contextualized data, so you might not even need to send raw logs. That choice is yours. It's something worth evaluating based on your use case. So far, we've looked at generic log collection methods, ones that apply across a wide range of environments and sources. But Datadog also offers a powerful shortcut, out-of-the-box integrations. These are built by the Datadog team specifically for popular services, and they go beyond just collecting logs. They often include predefined parsing rules, making your logs far easier to analyze right away. Let's dive into the documentation and see how these integrations are set up, and how they can give you a head start in making sense of your logs. Now let's go a bit deeper into some integrations that produce standard, well-known log formats. Head to the integration section in the Datadog docs. You'll find a full list of supported services there. Some of these integrations include log support. For example, if you open the Apache integration, you'll see detailed installation steps. By default, these pages focus on metrics, but scroll down and you'll find the log collection section. You'll need to enable logs and specify the log file path, just like we discussed earlier. That example is for host-based setups. If you're using Kubernetes, there's a similar process. Just add the right annotations to make sure the logs get properly collected and sent to Datadog. Since these are official integrations, remember, source is especially important to set correctly. Back on the Datadog platform, under Log Pipelines, you'll find the pipeline library at the top of the screen. This is where you'll find a complete list of available sources in Datadog. So if you need to define a source, say for Redis, you can search and select it from here. If I wanted to use Redis as my source, I just search for it in the list. Ideally, you want to use one of these predefined sources, because Datadog has built-in processes to parse and extract insights from them. These processes convert raw log strings into structured JSON, which makes them much easier to work with. And this structure also makes logs easier to manage across the platform. So remember, always check the available sources before picking one manually. With service, you have more flexibility. Just follow whatever naming convention your team already uses. Now let's move to a powerful configuration option available at the agent level, multi-line aggregation. In some cases, logs are not displayed in a single line, but a collection of lines. This does not really matter in a terminal where the main search criteria is time. However, at scale, it makes those logs more complex to search on. That's when the multi-line aggregation option helps you combine those logs into one logical unit for easier search. As a bonus, a single line index will cost less than if you were to index multiple ones. Let me show you how it works. Now pay close attention. Some applications generate logs that span multiple lines by default. Here's an example from a Java app. You can clearly see these lines belong to a single log event. By default, the agent treats them as four separate lines and indexes each one. That increases your indexing volume and your costs. Luckily, you can solve this with a multi-line aggregation rule. Here's how it looks. You configure the agent to monitor a specific file, and then define a processing rule that detects the start of a new log line using a custom pattern. If the pattern matches, it marks the beginning of a new log entry, grouping everything that follows as part of the same log. This also applies to Docker and Kubernetes logs. Datadog also supports automatic multi-line aggregation, which simplifies setup. This feature is available in newer agent versions. Just set auto_multi_line_detdetto true, and the agent will automatically detect and merge related log lines into one. The second important configuration I want to draw your attention to is log scrubbing and filtering. In many environments, logs can contain sensitive information, like credentials, personal data, or internal error traces that you don't want exposed or stored. The good news is that with Datadog, you can handle this at the agent level, meaning sensitive content can be scrubbed or filtered out before it ever reaches the platform. Let's walk through how to configure this properly, using the documentation, so you can stay compliant and secure while still collecting the logs that matter. If you're concerned your logs might contain emails, credit card numbers, or other sensitive info, the agent can filter or scrub that data before it reaches Datadog. The first method is log filtering, with two options: exclude underscore at underscore match and include underscore at underscore match. Let's look at exclude underscore at underscore match. In the config file, you can define a pattern, like a username or keyword, and any log matching it won't be sent to Datadog. For example, you might exclude all logs from internal Datadog users, saving cost by filtering out irrelevant internal activity. The more common method, though, is scrubbing, where you keep all logs but redact sensitive fields for privacy and compliance. Here's an example. You define a pattern to match credit card numbers, and the agent automatically replaces them with a placeholder before the logs are indexed. There are plenty of other examples, too. You can redact critical data like social security numbers or replace user emails with anonymized usernames. And if you're not a regex expert, no worries. The log management guide includes ready-to-use patterns to automatically redact things like emails, credit card numbers, SSNs, and postal codes. Take a look at those examples. They're a great starting point for safely scrubbing sensitive data from your logs. And that's a wrap. In this video, we explored a wide range of documentation to understand the many ways you can collect logs with Datadog, from file systems and containers to applications, browsers, and beyond. Datadog's goal is to make log collection as seamless as possible, so your data reaches the platform reliably, ready for analysis and action. In upcoming videos, we'll go beyond collection and focus on how to make sense of your logs, parsing them, structuring them, and building dashboards that bring out their full value. If you found this helpful, don't forget to subscribe and stay tuned. And as always, happy monitoring.